This is the bracket. Nice long tail for the bracket. Section. And what I do, most people mount them like so on the outside. Okay. I like tucking mine inside. That's the way I am. I just like that way. Okay. So what I do is I get my bolt, 7/16 bolt, and I'll shove it through, and then I'll get me a nut, 7/16 nut. Tighten her down there. Do the same thing to the other side, okay? So once I get that other side tightened down, I will show you what to do with the tail fin. Okay? Like I said, painting, you want to make sure you got to paint. It's not, you know, you happen to get like these tail arms. They're not painted with primer. You want to just clean them up with a little bit of denature alcohol or thinner, whatever it takes to get the pickling juice off the steel. Okay? They use that in manufacturing pickling juice quite a bit. Material from rusting. Okay? Starts oxidizing like aluminum as soon as it hits up. Any type of. Okay, so I'm gonna get the other one put on and I will show you how to mount the tail. Okay. Hey YouTubers, I'm gonna show you now how to put the arm tail bracket with the tail fin. Now, depending on what type of tail fin or tail that you buy, or what type of turbine you buy, depends on what type of tail fin you're gonna get. Okay, so I'm using these. They got a slotted hole. You see, slotted hole. And we're gonna put it together now, all right? So what I do is I'll take and put these two together like so. Line up the holes. And then push down on that. Make sure that it's all in line. My next hole lined up. Okay. And I'll squeeze it together. Pulling that nut in. Not nut, but bolt in place. And I'll squeeze it together like so. Okay. Now, if you don't have good hand strength like that, then I suggest you use a vice grip and hold it in place, okay? And do the same with the next hole. Of course, you can move it, because it's slotted, so you can move it, okay? To line up the hole in that, okay? That's a good thing Thermodyne puts in the tail. Feature, especially when you got sections that are like this. Okay, so get it in, give her a good push through, and then we'll tighten it down, just like so. Okay, get my 7/16 wrench out, along with the ratchet, tighten her down. Snug. There you go. All right. Now you're asking yourself a question. you're asking yourself the question, why are they using two pieces? Well, I can take and bend these out, be able to catch the wind better. Okay, so we'll bend them out a little. There we go. Or curvature to that bend. And if I need to add more of a tail, they also have extra holes here. The holes, extra holes. If I need to add a little more to it, so be it, I do. Well, if you catch, you know, it's not catching the wind the way you want it to. But, as you can see, now it's all together. There it is. Okay, next point, we'll be putting it on the pole, people. And be testing the power core 12 volt down. Okay? So this billy, I hope this helps out a little bit on how to put together a turbine. Okay? And painting, like I said, you just find you some good stuff to clean the metal with and acetone or something. And you'll be all right. Spray painted at will. Okay. They say, oh yeah, use sandpaper and all that, but you know what? People, I, as long as I've done turbines and putting them together and painting them and all that, you're still gonna have metal flake, or not metal flake, but paint chipping off from the weather, and you will still have any dusting going on because they are metal. So they come out with a completely aluminum or stainless turbine, you're gonna have metal. Okay. I'm thinking about, after I get done with the testing, I was thinking about doing a big powder coating on all my stuff. So it's all done then. All right, and this is Billy, and this is the turbine, people, that's going up for testing. Yes, it is. And I'm gonna be doing all type of blade tests on it, and along with a couple other PMAs, because I'm getting these kits put together now so I can just pull them off the pole and do another one, show another one right away. All right, this is Billy. Have a good one, and thanks.